Our next speaker is Ruth Coppinger, who's a TD, and here to talk to you about our abortion law, about the 8th Amendment and why reform in our maternity wards.
Friends, 2 years ago, 20,000 of us took to the streets after we heard about the torture, effectively, and eventual death of Savita Halappanavar. Unfortunately, we're here again today after another young woman has been tortured by the Irish state in defence of archaic and medieval abortion laws. Now, last year, a law was introduced, and the politicians assured us that this kind of thing just simply couldn't happen. All of the boxes in this case ticked. A rape victim who was suicidal, and yet she couldn't access a timely abortion when she first demanded one. It seems that the fear of the authorities within the HSE, within the various agencies, and also the hamstrung nature of this law has again brought about a terrible victim. Now, before going on to the politicians, I think we should say something about Spook, Life, and the Catholic right who held a vigil yesterday and have made pronouncements about this girl. How dare you? How dare you name a baby that has nothing to do with you? Of rape. Clearly not. What an insult when gender-based violence is at epidemic levels around the globe. To ignore the rights and the wishes of this terrible, that this girl experienced. How dare you decree that any woman should carry a pregnancy that she simply doesn't want to carry? It's not your choice. You have had your time. Your time was the Magdalene laundries. Your time was the mother and baby homes. The babies incarcerated in concrete under the ground. Your time was symphysiotomy, when pregnant women were brutalised and had their pelvises broken. That was your time. This is our time. But what all of those cases had in common is the common denominator was that the Irish state saw fit to take control over those women's lives, be it in the Magdalene laundries or the mother and baby homes or the pregnant women who were giving birth. The authorities knew best, and there's a long litany of these cases in the Irish state. There's going to be anniversaries coming up. For 90 years, we have to say that this backward-ridden capitalist state leaned on the church for support for far too long, and now that time should be well and truly up. So just in relation to what needs to be done now, the laws on suicidality, the granting automatically of visas for anyone who needs it for the right to travel should be there, and that could be brought in next week. The Dáil, in fact, should have been reconvened to discuss this disgraceful situation. And I've absolutely no doubt that it hasn't been reconvened to try to keep a lid on the situation, because the last time when Savita happened, obviously the presence of the Dáil assisted discussion and debate. But it isn't enough to sort out those things. We need to repeal the 8th Amendment to get it out of our constitution, so that women can make our own decisions. There shouldn't be any tribunals, any inquisitions or any panels to decide what women need and women want. That should be the choice of the woman herself. We need to stop ignoring the reality of four to, in fact, many more thousand to give Irish addresses, as we know, leaving this country every year for various reasons. But the problem is now that the poorest women, working class women, suffering the effects of austerity, are not going to be able to find 1,500 to 2,000 euros to access a service that should be provided in our health service here in this country. And we have to say no. And just find migrant population in my constituency in Dublin West is actually a quarter of the population are born outside of Ireland. Now, obviously not all of them have travel difficulties, but many of them do. This is going to happen again and again and again for those people. We need an active struggle. We can't go home. We have to keep the campaign going, because all of the lessons of the X case, of Civita, and in fact any gain that's been won for women in this country. It was an active struggle from below, not the politicians in the Dáil granting it from the goodness of their hearts, that forces them to act. My final message is to the Labour Party, and in particular to Joan Burton. There's a whole number of women in the Dáil who built their careers supposedly defending women's rights on the back of Mary Robinson's election campaign 20 plus years ago. Joan Burton is one of them. Her silence is absolutely shameful. Shame. We have to take the example from Spain. The Spanish government is backing down on they're diluting the draconian laws they were bringing in, because in 20 cities people took to the streets and said no. I support the campaign and the call by Rosa for more protests to increase the political pressure on the cowardly establishment that we have in the Dáil to take on the religious right, who've no longer got a basis in society whatsoever and are being given inordinate power by this government, way above and beyond. This generation will not sit idly by and wait for another 30 years. And the idea that there's no appetite, let's give them an appetite. Let's make sure that we take the campaign and we give them back their appetite.
That was Ruth Coppinger.